Iceland is a puppy that was born blind. When I showed up at Aloha Elio, she was one of the first dogs that I saw when I first walked in. Blind dogs are my absolute favorite to work with. I always say that they see with their heart. Since she's already spent 2 months in foster in Hawaii, she's pretty much ready for adoption. Now it's up to me to assess her personality and find the right family for her in my network.
Egypt. Come on,
hi, Spaniels. Welcome in committee. Okay, here we go.
She's like, why? Look at that tail up.
Welcome to the mainland.
Egypt was a very shy, timid girl in the shelter system in Hawaii. She was so timid, she did not want us to actually pet on her, love on her. She hid behind us. She was shaking. And I just knew I had to bring her home and work on her socialization. Socialization helps create trust between humans and animals. One of the biggest issues that we run into when it comes to fearful animals is that they haven't been properly socialized. And the fact that we have a teenage male, a teenage female, an adult female in the home, this animal is going to get all of the socialization they have missed out on.
All right, Chaz has to go.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, we're out of here.
You're amazing.
I love you guys. I'll see you guys soon.
Drive safe. Oh, you gotta be really extra careful because the blind girl is way under feet.
Hi.
She's so cute. Hey, Egypt. Egypt has only been here for 24 hours. She's already settling in beautifully, and she's totally night and day different than who she was in the shelter. With her, it's just gonna be a lot of boundaries, teaching her boundaries, and socialization and exercise and that sort of thing, but as you can see, she does really, really well in a family type home. Iceland is doing really well. She's 8 weeks old, so everything is brand new. She's adjusted really well with the pack. She's pretty mellow for a puppy her age. She definitely likes to play and she likes to wander around, but her favorite thing of all times is snuggling, for sure. Egypt, come here. Come here. And she's just now starting to learn how to navigate the house. After about 24 hours, she's kind of got some of it figured out.
Look at her, she's freaking nuts.
Egypt is a wild little maniac. She's a crazy monkey, zooms around the yard nonstop. She's so sweet. She's like one of the sweetest dogs, gives you the best kisses. But that lasts temporarily. It's like 5 seconds of slow down and then 2 hours of go, go, go.
I love her. She's a good girl. I can't wait for her to find a family so she can do this all day for the rest of her life.
My dogs are not a fan of hers. They're over it. We do major medical special needs hospice. We rarely do a healthy dog. Normally, that's when they come in a litter. We originally thought that she needed a ton of socialization and training. She definitely doesn't. She's very happy. She is not shy. So at this point, it's best for her to go to our rescue partners at Southwest, where they can find her a home sooner than later.
Iceland. Good girl, listen to my voice. Come here, over here. Oh, good girl, good girl, good girl. Boop, yummy. Good girl.
The next couple of weeks for Iceland is gonna be working on basic puppy stuff. Socializing, working on her mouthiness. Nothing different from a quote unquote normal puppy. Just from her time here, I can tell that Iceland's gonna need a home with an older dog in it that can really teach her the ropes, lead the way, and show her how to be the best dog she can be. I don't even know how I do interviews anymore with this puppy. There's a toy. Get it. You know what's really cool? Blind dogs have a motto, and it's ignorance is bliss. Like, blind dogs are by far one of my family's favorite dogs to take into rescue. They have no idea that they're any different. They don't miss what they don't know.
You wanna go meet the oink?
Oh my gosh, she's so cute.
You're gonna start crying.
Oh wow.
I started following Amanda after really good friends of ours sent us a video of Duncan on the beach.
Come on, Oink. Oink! Come on, buddy.
Oink has completely blown us away. It's hard to put into words how capable a blind and deaf dog is. He's like any of our other dogs. We forget all the time that he's blind and deaf.
I think blindness creates a stigma. So for me, it's always been a mission to prove that stigma wrong and show the world that blind dogs can live totally normal, happy lives.
We're here.
Hi. come on in.
Well, I've heard you've only had Elliot now 2 days.
Yeah, just a couple days. Okay. He came to us from a breeder who their veterinarian recognized that he had a heart condition. And you wow. can feel kind of like the washing machine, okay. you know?
Okay.
As soon as I picked him up, I was like, oh, what are you washing in there?
There's certainly different tests we do to evaluate the heart.
Mm-hmm.
The echocardiogram is by far the most important and helpful test to identify heart disease. It'll tell us the severity of the problem. I am gonna need to dim the lights. This textured tissue that's largely in a circular pattern, that's one of the chambers of his heart, and you'll see it contract. And that's, you know, the blood-filled cavity. I am seeing evidence of a PDA.
You are seeing a PDA?
Yes.
Okay. PDA stands for patent ductus arteriosus. It's an open vessel in the heart that naturally closes at birth. When it doesn't, it creates this turbulent abnormal blood flow that you can hear, which is called a murmur.
You see where this little green jet is originating?
Uh-huh. Looks like a tornado.
It looks like a tornado.
Got it.
That is where the PDA orifice or hole is. I am seeing some damage to the heart because of the PDA.
A lot of that blood flow is getting kicked back into the chamber over and over and over again, causing thickening in the heart wall, causing the heart to have to work harder than it really needs to.
That can improve by closing the PDA. His isn't so far damaged that I would expect irreparable consequences. Yeah, if we can get it fixed soon, we should.
Okay.
On average, dogs with an uncorrected PDA go into congestive heart failure between 1 and 1.5 years of age. Whereas if you fix them, they typically live a normal life. You can do an open chest procedure. They usually make an incision between the ribs and physically suture that PDA. Very effective and is a great option.
We have his heart surgery booked. Yes, he has a PDA. No, that's not wonderful news, but all in all, knowing that we have a heart situation in front of us, this is one of the best outcomes you could come up with. Okay, bud, let's get out of here.
You remember this place? Huh? You're so brave, buddy.
Hey,
Amanda.
Good
morning. This is Elliot.
Hello, Elliot. Quite a little washing machine in there.
I know.
So is he pretty active at home?
Very.
Normal activity?
Very. Doing excellent. I've only had to stop him in play like 2 or 3 times. Other than that, he's very self-limiting and go, go, go.
Okay. And he's not on any heart medications?
No heart medications, no.
Well, essentially what we do is we tie off this abnormal blood vessel. And that may sound pretty straightforward, but it is a small, short, little blood vessel.
Mm-hmm.
And it's in a little cul-de-sac where you can't really see around it. So you have to somewhat blindly pass your suture around it. And the biggest concern would be a significant hemorrhage. They could very quickly bleed to death.
Right. Without this surgery, he will have a very short life.
Yeah, the outlook is usually quite poor. And fortunately, it is one of the few that is surgically correctable.
Right.
All right, bud.
You're gonna do so good.
Yes. Yes, they're gonna fix your heart.
Anytime you go into cardiology surgery, it is a moving muscle in the body. It takes one wrong move, one very small millimeter, and it could mean the difference between survival and death.
So he did very well. No complications, went pretty smoothly.
Good.
And so it's just a matter of keeping him quiet, and cardiology will follow up. He may have a little bit of a residual heart murmur,
right.
But that typically will resolve. Sometimes it can take several months.
Can I give you a hug?
You got it.
I appreciate you. Thank you so much. You just saved his life.